nearsighted. Like, come on, gotta be nearsighted and farsighted. Get you a guy who does both. And I'm welcome to the stage another very talented comedian, Mr. Liam Paris.
What's up? Does anybody do like drying clothes or anything? That was funny, okay? I'm sorry. April Fools. Man, I'd start this one. What am I doing? I'm really nervous about this set for a lot of different reasons. My parents are in the audience with my brothers. I'm gonna talk to you about some material from my life that, like, I've been holding and sitting on forever, because I've always really wanted to use it in like a longer like hour or like one man show. I'm only gonna do 5 minutes tonight, so we're not even gonna get to dive fully into it. But this is the most expensive bit that I have ever worked on. And it's all the car accidents I've been in. I've been in at least 8 car accidents. I got a ticket for reckless driving, I got a ticket, a parking ticket, and I got a ticket for texting while driving. But I can explain that because I wasn't texting. But before we get into it, just some ground rules. I've never been hurt in any of these, and I think that's like the worst thing, because you can't really feel bad for me at all. All of these save one were my fault, and I don't have it. I can't be like, ugh, but also my arm was hurt. Like, no, I walked out of these unscathed every fucking time. And also, even though I did get that ticket, which I'll explain later, every other time, I am never on my phone. I don't like plug my phone into the radio or anything. Like, I just listen to the radio. So, and like only one of them had like ice out. So like all of these are just because I just can't function as a human being. And that is also like the worst thing in the world, because like there's no, you know, there's no special license for me being like a fuck up. Like, oh, class D means that he can't actually focus on the road. That's what I can't do. But we're just gonna get right into this. Since I can't tell all of them, I actually just wrote them all out, and I want someone to yell out a number between 1 and 8.
7.
Okay. Number 7 was this is a tamer one, so can we start off with this, I guess. I was driving with my brother. And I went for it, and it was a red light, and I just thought it was a green light, and there was a car in front of me, and I gave a little love tap. More of them are like that than you'd think. There were some that are really bad, but most of them are just like, I just started going and hit the next car. This one was crazy, because I hit this woman, and like, it looked like the car was totally fine, like it was just a little tap, and so I thought everything was gonna be okay, and she was like, oh, I have this rear-facing camera in my car, and you broke it, like, you're gonna have to, like, get, like, you're gonna have to pay for this and stuff. We didn't do their insurance. I don't think my parents even knew about this until I'm just, did you know about that?
No.
No. But so I tapped this woman, and she's like, you're gonna hear from me in a little bit, I'll tell you what the damages are. And then she got back to me like a month later and was like, oh, everything turned out to be fine. But she was a realtor, and she put me on her mailing list. And I'm like, I can't drive a fucking car, why do you think I could finance a house? next number?
3.
3. I heard 3. Okay, this one's sad. It was really snowy. I was in a Honda station wagon that my father loved. I was leaving my high school, and it was really snowy out, and it goes down a huge hill. And so I was like, all right, I guess I'll just like start to drive. And then I realized it was a horrible idea right as I went down, and then I just slowly slowly, slowly slid until I hit the edge of the road, which had like a stone lining. And I was like, oh, I mean, what's the worst that could happen? Bent the axle, $700, and pay it myself. Real lame. It's not even funny anymore, we're just talking about it. Another number.
Five.
Okay, so this is the accident that ruined that car. driving, and I'm in Morristown, New Jersey. And this woman just pulled out without even looking, and we just T-boned. And my car was totaled. I had a friend in the car with me, and she freaked out so much that we were like maybe like 15 minutes away from school. So she was just like, oh, I gotta go. It's just left. And then the woman that I hit had to go to the hospital. Even though it was her fault, I still fucked up. I still had to keep cop comes up to me, he's like, you know, it was a good thing that you had the instincts to swerve out of the way because you could have killed her. And I was like, yeah, those instincts. I'm out of time, so I'm gonna leave you guys on this one, which you know, really just encapsulates it all. I was driving home from a party, and I had a girl in the car that I really wanted to impress. And we were coming back, and I was at this intersection, and we came, and I had to like swerve out of the way a little bit because I started turning, this other car started turning, it was bad. Everything was fine, but then a cop pulled me over, and this was in the early stages of like my car accident, so it wasn't, you know, I was still smooth. I was like, maybe I can charm this cop, impress this girl, two birds, one stone, everything's gonna be great. So he comes up, he's like, do you know I pulled you over? He's like, yeah, I mean, I screwed up there, I'm really sorry. I just, like, wasn't thinking and forgot the way that cars work. So he's like, okay, let me get your license and registration, takes it, goes back, comes back, just looks at me for a minute, looks around at the car, and then he goes, you know what? You've gone through enough. You're good. And I was very confused, but I was also like, fuck yeah. I'm a fucking man. This girl's gonna love me. And then I drive her home, and we get out of the car, and I'm saying goodbye. And I notice that I had a parking ticket on my car already. that I had gotten when we were at that party. So that cop came over, was like, I gotta get this guy a ticket. Looks up, sees the other ticket. And she goes, oh boy. That's my time.